Good morning. There's your trouble. It is 5 o'clock on Tuesday morning, and we're here. All right. That's it. Okay. But getting on with connective tissue notes. Here we go. Connective tissue. We just refresh our memory a little bit because we're going to have a quiz tomorrow. Yeah, that's right. Mañana. After today. And so remember, connective tissues have cells of some sort that are embedded in extracellular matrix or stuff that they secrete around them and fill in the stuff. This stuff is hard or smooth or various characteristics, sometimes fibers, but that material is technically not made of cells, is not alive in that sense of the word, but it does have cells embedded in it that are actually still alive. All right, we start from hardest, went our way to softest. Bones are obviously the hardest. The type of cells is osteocytes, and then they secrete the bone material or the calcium salts and make the actual hard bone. All right, then we had cartilage, which is softer than bone, but can be very hard, especially hyaline cartilage. It has made out of chondrocytes. Chondro means cartilage cells, basically. So there we go. And then it secretes a matrix of cartilage, different types of cartilage, hard, soft, and then also fibers in the case of fibrocartilage. Now, the last is, not last, next two are dense and loose connective tissue. Okay, both of these have fibroblasts because they're cells that create fibers. All right. And they have a matrix of different types of collagen or protein fibers. Now, there are two main groups of this dense connective tissue. You have the regular, which runs side by side, parallel, and these are make tendons and ligaments. So they're very strong in that one direction, but they're not very strong if you pull or twist them from side to side, which is why they often get injured. Then you have irregular, which means it goes in all different directions, and that is like in your dermis, and that means it's strong in all directions, so it doesn't tear or rip in any direction, which is a good thing. And all of that has a poor blood supply, all right, which means they do not heal very fast because there's no nutrients and food and stuff like that being sent to them very well. So they're very slow to heal. All right, and then we have loose connective, which we'll talk more about today. And they're also made of fibroblasts. They also have fibers, but they tend to be softer. They have more cells, less fibers, and a lot of loose, empty spaces between them, okay, which is why they're called loose connective tissue. Fancy that. All right. And then last but not least, we have blood. Somehow I think I missed blood on the last one we did. But anyhow, blood is on the connective tissue. Okay? Blood, we're not going to talk a lot of detail about it because it will be on the... we'll do a whole chapter on blood in the spring. But a couple things. One, the cells, the only cells in it are red blood cells. However, they're a little different. They do not have any fibers or anything like that, except when your blood clots. Then it will start forming fibers. And so it's a little different than all the other connective tissues in that you don't just have one kind of blood cell that does it. Also, the blood is produced in the red bone marrow, okay, and so are the fibers as well as that. And so the actual blood does not have cells and matrix like the rest of these that we talk about do. All right, cartilage, we're going to go to talk about it more specifically. We did that last time. Avascular, no blood vessels, so it once again does not heal. Chondrocytes, which means that those are the cells that make the different kind of cartilage. Hyaline cartilage is a hard, very almost glassy, very rigid, feels almost like bone from the outside. You couldn't tell the difference. Your larynx and your esophagus, where your ribs attach to your breast bone, the end of your bones have very smooth, hard layers of cartilage on them, and your fetal skeleton is made of hyaline cartilage before it's replaced by bone. All right, and then we have fibrocartilage, which has a bunch of fibers in it, and it allows your backbone, that's where we find it mostly between the backbone disc, to be tough, very stringy, tough hanging on to each other, but they also allow some flexibility so that you can bend your body. And finally, elastic cartilage, which is in your nose, in your ears, very floppy, not nearly as hard. But mostly not as much fibers in it. Okay, just basically cartilage material. All right. Which brings us to today's notes, which are the loose connective tissue. All right. First up, we're going to talk about our areolar. And the name areolar just means basically small empty spaces. All right. And main purpose of these kind of tissues are to cushion and protect organs, okay? Because since they are soft and they give a little cushiony, kind of like a sponge in a way, because they have all these empty spaces in them, so they are, they help cushion and protect your organs, all right? Now, they also soak up excess fluid because they are like a sponge and they have these spaces between all the fibers. And so it allows it to soak up. So, if, for example, if a tissue is damaged, then the areolar tissue can soak up some of that excess fluid. All right. And here's an example of a picture. Okay, once again, notice you have a bunch of fibers, bunch of empty spaces. So once again, that's why we know this is not dense connective tissue. There's a lot of empty spaces. Not much cells, though. Okay, very few cells, lots of empty spaces. And so that's how it can cushion, but also how it can soak up a lot of extra fluids in case there's damage to tissue and things like that. So this tissue is found around most of the organs in your body. It's kind of like a clear wrapping tissue. And like I said, it kind of helps protect it, cushion it, but it also soaks up fluid. Now, if you have edema, E-D-E-M-A, edema, or swelling in your tissue, a lot of times, for example, as people get older, their feet swell because they don't have good circulation. But if you have excess fluids like that or edema, it is this tissue that is soaking up the fluid and swelling up. Okay? All right. So moving on to our next one. There we go. Adipose tissue. All right. Adipose. What does adipose mean? Well, it turns out basically it's a fancy name for fat cells. Okay? So if you have fat cells, they are basically adipose tissue. Okay? Now, where do you find adipose tissue? Well, it depends, okay? Generally, underneath your skin, we have what we call the hypodermis, okay? Which hypo means less than or below. And so in this case, it's below the dermis or below your skin. I sometimes call it subcutaneous fat, okay? And this is the fat layer below your skin, okay? And so almost all of your skin underneath it has this fat layer below it, and we collect a certain amount of fat there. When we look at the roadkill autopsy, hopefully we will get to see some of that. Now, so if some is saved underneath your skin, that's usually a sign of healthy. If we look at a good healthy animal on the roadkill, usually it'll have some there. Usually around your kidneys, okay? For some reason, the kidneys are a good place to save it. Probably helps cushion the kidneys against blows as they're up against the backbone. And women, particularly around the hips, guys tend to, as they get older, especially tend to get a pot belly in the belly. And of course, the breast tissue of women are primarily fat. Okay. And we have sometimes pointed out that the ideal woman, supposedly sexy, whatever, is to have large breasts, which is large fat tissue, but to be very slim, which means you don't have any fat tissue. And so that's why most of what you see in Hollywood, a lot of it anyhow, has been augmented by surgeries, etc., because you're kind of going against type. You're trying two different things, low fat level throughout your whole body, but high fat level in the breast tissue. And so that's, you know, just pretty much an impossible thing to have. And so you can save yourself a lot of time, energy, not trying to do the impossible. All right, just be happy with the body you have. All right, that's Mr. McMurray's body image message for the day. Now, fat's purpose is, one, to insulate, okay, particularly in your skin. That helps to insulate you and keep you warm. But its other main purpose is that it is to store energy, okay? And because we said, if you remember, fat has 9 calories per gram, so it's a very efficient way to store energy. It doesn't take very much of it to store a lot of energy, and so it's your body's way of storing up against a rainy day or perhaps a dry day where there's no food, no whatever, drought, whatever, and you can draw on these fat reserves when you need to, okay? Now, if you look at the tissue, so there's breast tissue there, All right, here's a close-up of the cells. Now, if you look at the cells, fat cells are basically just big storage organs for fat, okay? And so they have a nucleus and the cytoplasm, this little sliver around it. Sometimes these are called signet ring cells. Signet, S-I-G-N-E-T, by kings who had used to put their signet into hot wax to show that it came from them. But anyhow, the point is it looks like a ring with just a big blob here in the middle where your finger would go. All right, that's all the fat that's being stored there, okay? And so storing all the fat, that is basically all they do. They don't really have much function other than that, okay? I was going to say something, but I've lost it. Okay, they do have a secondary. They do help since it's underneath your skin. It does help a little bit with cushioning, but really the main two things I would say is insulating and storing energy. All right, now reticular loose connective tissue. All right, is interwoven fibers that form a framework of spleen, lymph nodes, and bone marrow. Okay, so reticular has a bunch of fibers, okay, more fibers, if you will, but it also has a lot of cells. And so in this case, it just makes a framework, if you will, to make organs. So a lot of organs are built out of this, okay? Your spleen, which is over below your stomach on the left-hand side, all right, is made out of this. It's a semi-hard, semi-squishy organ because of this. It has the fibers with the cells all on it. All right, your lymph nodes, which you have in your throat, you have in your armpit. You have several places scattered all over your body, armpit, but also down in the groin area have a particularly high concentration. Your lymph nodes are made of reticular loose connective tissue. All right. And your bone marrow. Bone marrow is, if you've ever cracked open a bone or like a chicken bone, you see that it's usually kind of brown by the time it's been cooked, but red tissue there in the middle, that is the bone marrow. Okay. And it is also, it's even more squishy probably than all the others. All right. And as you can see, you have some fibers that make like a framework. Cursor. There we go. Okay, so you have some fibers in there, lots of cells on it, just enough to make a framework of the organ. This would be an example of your spleen. Okay. All right. All right. First of all, Mr. McMurray made a typo. He thought, why don't I use the color version because it's prettier and whatever. And I forgot there was a typo on it, and that's why I use this black and white version. There should not be blood up here. It is part of a loose connective tissue, and it does not belong with this particular part. Okay, so if you'll please make that correction, get rid of the blood up there. And now let's go back to our loose connective tissue. All right, and that brings us to our final slide. Here we go. Ms. McMurray can get it right this time. Blood should be under loose connective tissue. And the matrix in blood is a little bit different than any of the others in that there is not really a fibers or whatever. The plasma or the liquid part of the blood is considered the matrix. So if you look at a picture of blood down here, you have plasma. Well, the plasma is kind of a pale yellowish fluid between here. It looks a lot like pale urine because a lot of the waste products come from the blood. It's very wet. So that's the matrix, okay? Now, there are protein fibers that will clot when necessary, but they float around as a dissolved chemical in the liquid most of the time. Only when there's an injury, then they start forming. And when we look at these in the spring, you'll be looking at the field and it's just a bunch of red blood cells. And also bing, 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 there'll be all these little black lines just popping up. Well, those are the liquid being converted into a solid protein fiber. And that's what makes the scab and stops the bleeding and so forth. So it does have fibers, but only when the tissue has been injured, okay? And if you look at the picture here, all right, you see the red blood cells. There are just trillions and trillions of red blood cells. It's hard to overestimate how many. And your body is constantly making more of them. And this is one reason why when you have cancer treatments, they can get anemia because it attacks all these rapidly dividing cells to replace it. You have a few of these purple centers that we'll look at will stain the blood. These are white blood cells that are part of your immune system and help fight disease and things like that. But that brings us to blood, which is the final loose connective tissue. All right, that's it for today. Have a good day, if it's not too late already. If it is, have the best day possible.